Our prayer says, I bear witness, O my God, that thou hast created me to know thee and to worship thee. God has created us for two things. Each one of us, the whole humanity, has been created for two things. To know the Creator, know our Father of soul, and to worship him means to obey the Creator, act upon the teachings of the Creator. So knowing the teachings of God means knowing God means knowing the teachings of God. And once we know the teachings of God, we should act upon them. That is the purpose of life for which we have all been created. God has sent his messages for our guidance, to make us wiser. He has sent books of wisdom. He has revealed certain books to the manifestations of God. And these manifestations of God, they have given these books, revealed these books. This Bhagavad Gita has been revealed by God to Krishna. This teaches justice. Nyayat apne bandhu ko bhi dand dena dharma hai. For the sake of justice, even you have to punish your brother, your family members, punish them, but to run the society properly, justice in society, justice in the workplace, justice in the family, and justice is everywhere. That is the very, very important quality for running the society. It is a social teaching as well as ethical teaching, both. This book is full of thousands and thousands of teachings revealed by one God for the whole of humanity. Unfortunately, Hindus think this book has come for them. This is ignorance, because the book has been, it is not written by Krishna. It has been revealed by God to Krishna. And Krishna gave it to Arjuna. And through the Arjuna, we came to know all this teaching, the wisdom. It is, what is this book? This is a book of wisdom. This book makes us wiser in life. It gives us guidance, how to do, how be wiser. And if we take decisions with wisdom, we are successful. And if we take decisions which are out of ignorance, we have to suffer. So we must have the wisdom. These are all books of wisdom. This was 2,500 years ago. This wisdom was given by the same God who has sent this book to Buddha. This is called Tripitaka. It teaches us we are all equal in the sight of God. Nobody is upper caste or nobody is lower caste. The caste system was created out of ignorance, that too by man, not by God. God has not created any caste, upper caste or lower caste or middle caste. God has created us all equal. We are all equal. Nobody is upper caste, nobody is lower caste. So he gave the teaching of samyajnana. That means we are all equal in the sight of God. And there are thousands of teachings. They are all wisdom, but the main teaching I have told you. 2,000 years ago, another wisdom came to Jesus from same God, because God is only one. There are no different gods for Krishna or for Buddha or Jesus or Muhammad or Guru Nanak Ji or Bab or Baha'u'llah or Zoroaster or Moses or Abraham or Mahavir. There are not so many gods. God is only one. And these are all books of wisdom from same God. So this is a book of wisdom. The main teaching of this is this earth will belong to those who are kind and compassionate. So kindness and compassion have been told as the strength of a man. If you want to become strong in life, be kind and compassionate. That makes you strong. And that makes you The kingdom of earth belongs to those who are kind and compassionate. You can be the king of this world through kindness and compassion. So this was the message, and there are thousands and thousands of teachings, but the main message is this. This is the message of God, and they are all messages of one God. What is the message? They are the book of wisdom. All the revealed books of God are unerring. There is no mistake in it. If all the people of the world together want to find out a mistake in Bhagavad Gita or Quran or Bible or Guru Granth Sahib or Tripitaka or Kitab like this, they cannot. Because they are books not written by the manifestations of God. Gita is not written by someone who was born or who died. All these manifestations of God were born and they died. See, they are not the books of someone who was born and who died. They are the wisdom of the one who never takes birth, who never dies, who is eternal. So these are the books from someone who neither takes birth, who never dies. He is a soul. He is a creator. He is the power. He is the one who has created moon and the sun and the sky, and we are all in the whole world, and he is in everywhere. There is no place where he is not available. So they are all wisdom of God, and unerring, and collected wisdom. These are unerring and collected wisdom. Who collected this wisdom? God himself. Since when? Since the day one, when created this earth. He collected this wisdom, and 5,000 years ago, he put it into Bhagavad Gita. 2,500 years ago, he again put the whole wisdom up to 2,500 years ago in Tripitaka. And 2,000 years ago, since the day one till 2,000 years ago, all the wisdom is enshrined in Holy Bhagavad Gita. And Holy Quran, 1,400 years ago, the wisdom of God came to Holy Quran. The first verse of Quran says, Khuda is Rabbul Alameen. He is the Rabb of the whole world. He is the creator of the universe. He is the creator of the sun and the moon and the sky and all people. Allah is the creator. You can call him Allah, you can call him God, you can call him Bhagwan, you can call him Rabb, you can call him any name. These are the names given by us. God has no name, because he has never taken birth. He has no mother or father. Names are kept when a child takes birth. God has never taken birth. God is self-created. God is the power. Everywhere. He is outside me, he is inside me, he is on the top, he is on the left, he is on the right, he is at the back. No place is there in this universe where God is not existing. God is omnipotent. The God who never takes birth. Where from these names came? People, when they came to this earth to live, they realized that there is some power. Must be there have been some power. Who has created earth, who has created sun and the moon and the sky, who has created air and water, and all these things, there must be someone. So to pray him, to remember him, they kept the names. English-knowing people kept his name as God. Arabic-knowing people kept his name as Rab or Rabbul Alameen. Urdu-knowing people kept his name as Allah or Khuda. Hindi-knowing people kept his name as Bhagwan, Ishwar, Paramatma. Likewise, the German, French, Russian, Spanish, all the nationalities are here. They have different names. He has thousands and thousands of names. God has innumerable names. But God has no name. God is only soul. Jesus Christ, when he was put to cross, he was asked, how do you say that you are the Son of God? And the king asked the people, who were in the assembly. Well, Jesus, right? He says, I am the son of God. They said, no, no, no. He is the son of Joseph, carpenter. And the king said, where does he live? And somebody said, yes, sir, he is here. Call him here. He was called. And he was asked, he is your son? Joseph, carpenter, said, yes, he is my son. Then the king asked Jesus, he is your father? Yes, he is my father. But then why do you say that you are the son of God? Then he said, O king, everybody has two fathers. One is the father of my body, and one is the father of my soul. He is the father of my body, physical body. And God is the father of my soul. Dear friends, we all have two fathers. One is the father of physical body, one is the father of soul. He is the father of soul. He has sent all these holy books. Quran teaches us Khuda Rabbul Alameen. The message of Quran is peace, unity, love, understanding. Quran is a book which teaches that you do not eat food till you see that everybody has eaten food. No hungry should remain. If anybody is hungry, you give him food first. Quran teaches never hurt anyone. Quran teaches so many good things. These are all being sent by one God for you. All these, this is a book of wisdom. Quran, what is Quran? Quran makes us wiser. It's a book of wisdom. And then 550 years ago, this book came to the heart of Nanak. It says, Abbal Allah Noor Upaya, Kudrat ke sab bande, aur ek noor te sab jagubja, kon bale kon mande. Aur Nanak naam chardi kala, jab tere bhane sarvat tadabala. This book says, the whole humanity has been born from one God. We are all creations of one God. Nanak naam. And then he says, Nanak naam chardi kala. The name of Nanak can take you towards God. But there is a condition. He says, Nanak naam chardi kala kab jab tere bhane sarvat tada bhala. When you do good to the whole of humanity, sacrifice for the whole of humanity, then only Nanak's name can take you towards God. If you want to realize God, the only way is to serve the whole of humanity. That is the way. And then 200 years ago, another book came in the heart of Baha'u'llah, that was the Baha'i teachings. The Kitab-e-Aqdas and so many books have come. All these manifestations of God were illiterate. They were not educated. They have not written these books. No one has written these books. Neither Muhammad has written Quran. Muhammad is a recipient of Quran, teachings of Quran. God's messenger, Farishta, angel came, and he was giving these teachings, beautiful teachings. And he kept on sending these teachings, God kept on sending teachings for 23 long years. All these teachings were written on the palm leaf or at the back of the sheep, the skin of the sheep, dried skin of the sheep. And they were collected and they were printed and this holy Quran was made. So Quran is not written by Muhammad. Quran was given to Muhammad by God. So all these teachings were not written by them. Baha'u'llah teaches us, my God, unite the hearts of thy servants and reveal to them thy great purpose. May they follow thy commandments and abide in thy law. Help them, O God, in their endeavor and grant them strength to serve thee. O God, leave them not to themselves, but guide their steps by the light of thy knowledge and cheer their hearts by thy love. Verily, thou art the helper and the Lord. So my God, unite the hearts. When God created this earth, he wanted He created the earth and he wanted some children to come to this earth so that they can play and enjoy and sing songs and do some dance, and he will enjoy it. He thought of it. He is a creator. He decided, let us have some children. So he made a husband and wife. He created one husband and one wife. That was Adam and Eve. One mother and one father. So that the children can be born and they can come and play and enjoy, and God will see them and he will enjoy. He is the creator, he decided. So he created Adam and Eve. And any father to his children will always give something good, some teachings, some good teachings. We all give our children some good teachings for the benefit of those children. So also God gave the teaching. And what was the teaching? Teaching was the religion. What is the religion? God taught them the first lesson of God taught them the religion. The religion is, he told to both of them, live in unity and live in peace. That is the religion. Never break unity and never break peace. If you are in unity, peace will automatically come to you. So he taught the first lesson of unity. And unity is possible, all your hearts are pure. Unity is not possible without hearts being pure.
May CMS fragrance fill the sky, and its name endure forever and aye. May its founders' ideals inspire, to strive, to seek, to ever aspire. May we uphold the good and fair in all that we do and dare. At home, at school, at play, in actions of the day. Is a temple of learning, where knowledge and wisdom rules, where we become the changes we dream of. Our most beloved school, our lessons are of peace and is of spirituality. Our greetings for all is Jagat. Our vision is of world unity. Unique in the annals of education, our founder is a one of a kind. We are the light of the world, and CMS, the hope of mankind. May CMS fragrance fill the sky, and its name endure forever and aye. May its founders' ideals inspire, to strive, to seek, to ever aspire. May we uphold the good and fair in all that we do and dare. At home, at school, at play, in actions of the day. At school, at play, in distractions of the day. Gradually, as the arts of life improved, the forests cleared, lesser natural regions fused into greater, advancements in science, technology, World Wide Web, and now the advent of artificial intelligence, it may perhaps be thought that with the continuance of this process, all mankind will be in the end unified. Man's oldest dream to establish one world state or world government with an established world parliament and world court of justice. If human civilization is not to go down in blind internecine conflicts since the bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki and the recent spread of international terrorism, global warming, stockpiling of weapons of mass destruction, fear of a third world war and nuclear holocaust, there must be a development of world planning for world federalism as enshrined in the ancient Indian wisdom of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, or earth is but one country and mankind its citizens. Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Is it a tenable dream? Perhaps so. As for the past 6 decades now, Guinness World Records holder City Montessori School in Lucknow, India, founded by Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, who remains active as ever as the nerve center of his school community, has redesigned his school syllabus through the integration of education, religion, law, and justice to create world-minded and socially conscious citizens who would work for the welfare of humanity and its unity. Unity will bring divine civilization on earth, and to make it happen, CMS, the winner of the UNESCO Prize for Peace Education in 2002 through its curriculum of education for protection and security since the turn of the century, has been convening the international conferences of chief justices of the world that aims to unite the world for children through enforceable international law and effective global governance. CMS students and management have been fervently asking for a safe and secure world, especially for the 2.5 billion children of the world and generations yet to be born. A democratic world government based on establishing peace and solving environmental problems. And here is their appeal to the President of the United States of America, Mr. Donald Trump. Team CMS received 370 dignitaries consisting of chief justices, judges, heads of states, speakers of parliaments, ambassadors, legal luminaries and world unity promoters from 71 countries who were graciously welcomed to participate in the 19th International Conference of Chief Justices of the World on Article 51 of the Constitution of India, headed by the convener of the conference, founder of City Montessori School, Dr. Jagdish Gandhi.
Well, I spoke about the importance of understanding childhood and how children learn by imitating, repeating, and internalizing what they see from the parents. And therefore that the normal child is one who enjoys the love and support of a family at home, and they learn from copying the mannerisms, and the awareness is heightened by what they observe, and they repeat that, and if what they do is rewarded by acknowledgement and encouragement and nurturing, it defines who they become later in life. Mm-hmm. And so, as Nelson Mandela says, that human beings learn how to hate, and therefore they can also learn how to love.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. Actually, if we can do away with the emotion of hate or cut down on it in some mm-hmm. way, you know, it'll be a beautiful world for all of us. That is what that encourages the use of nuclear weapons. That is what that encourages all kinds of, you know, ambiguities to creep in.
Well, later in life, of course, you know, societies are structured in a way which I made the point here that society has evolved and developed over a succession of socioeconomic formations, beginning with communalism when the means to support life were owned communally by a community, mm-hmm. and they share the responsibilities and everything else, and they look after each other. Mm-hmm. The orphans are looked after by the community and so on. And then, of course, society got to a stage where it divided into classes. Mm-hmm. Hence you have slaves and slave owners, and once again progressed to feudalism, which is also a class-divided society. And eventually we are under capitalism, it's a class-divided society. You have those who today, I made the point, the statistics, that 1% of the wealthiest people in the world own wealth which is equivalent to that owned by 50% of the world population. And so this is an inequitable situation and not sustainable. And however, we must acknowledge that the system of capitalism is unparalleled when it comes to knowing how to create wealth. But it is totally ignorant on how that wealth should be distributed equitably. And this is a fundamental contradiction which drives young people to leave their motherlands, to go elsewhere in search of the promise of wealth and opportunity at a high risk. I mean, in Africa we have many young people dying, drowning in the Mediterranean Sea, trying to cross into Europe. In America, Latin America, hundreds of thousands of people try to get into the United States. And the point I made also, the last point I made, was that instead of living by the dictum of saying, I am my brother's keeper, we close them out. We close them out through our borders. Donald Trump has promised or threatened to build a wall between America and Mexico, mm-hmm. to keep the Mexicans out. So I also made the point that the ban on Muslims in America is something that should not be taken lightly, because it all begins with this kind of attitude towards others, when in fact what is needed is for us to relate to each other as fellow human beings.
Who believes in it today? No matter how much religious we are, no matter how much we say, how much lip service we do that we believe in an equal society, we really do not do in the heart of our hearts, and that is why we do not see it happening. As simple as that.